making his entrance to the ring, please welcome the reigning and defending world champion, AJ Anthony Joshua!
Being in camp and getting right back in after he got this fight, and there he goes!
Получится.
Еще раз открытый, да, падает.
There's a from White, but the legs are betraying him, and down he goes. Because Takam's not going to win this. Anthony Joshua now retains his...
This guy is a fighter at his core.
At the dawn of a new era, a young warrior emerged in a sport hungry for a hero, rising from obscurity to become a unified heavyweight champion. With fists like thunder and a spirit that refused to be defeated, he would embark on a journey that would captivate the world. But behind the mighty punches and the undying spirit lies a story that unfolds like a script from a Hollywood blockbuster. This is the story of Anthony Joshua, the making of a unified heavyweight champion. They say champions are not born, but made. And the making of Anthony Joshua, the unified heavyweight champion, is a tale that will leave you on the edge of your seat, hungry for more. From Watford, England's streets, to the heavyweight division's pinnacle, Anthony Joshua's journey is a tapestry of trials, triumphs, and the pursuit of greatness. In the early life of Anthony Joshua, a future heavyweight champion was born.
As a baby, he was a very chubby little boy, a very good baby actually.
On October 15th, 1989, in Watford, Hertfordshire, England, a young boy with boundless energy and a passion for sports emerged from a Nigerian-British household.
I grew up in North Watford, a place called Meriden Estate, where I had all my cousins and aunties and uncles live like within 2 minute walking distance of each other, so growing up I always had family around me.
Football was his first love and he excelled in the sport, even catching the eye of the Watford Football Club's youth academy.
He was actually quite a gentleman in PE, loved the subject, really interested in it, but it's probably fair to say that he was not so great in some of the other areas, but when every time he came down to the PE department he was absolutely outstanding. We had no problems at all.
He kind of got interested in boxing much, much later on. I think he was probably when he was about 18 or so. But prior to that, he had always been into like football and athletics and all sorts, gymnastics and all of those things, but nothing, no. Boxing was happened later on.
But destiny had a different path in mind for Anthony Joshua. At the age of 18, a pivotal moment changed the course of his life forever. It was his cousin who introduced him to the world of boxing, leading him to the hallowed halls of the Finchley Amateur Boxing Club in North London.
My cousin came around and saw me with all these weights, kind of laughing at what I was doing.
Number one, he was doing the weights were too light. He was just doing all the wrong exercise, so I thought, I'm just showing him a couple of things, and then from then he's being like a sponge, just soaks everything up.
There, under the guidance of skilled trainers and surrounded by fellow aspiring fighters, Joshua discovered his true calling.
I told him I want to get fit, I want to get stronger, and he said, why don't you come for a real workout? Come see what I get up to down the boxing gym.
Day after day, Joshua poured his heart and soul into refining his skills, honing his technique, and building his strength. Despite starting his boxing journey relatively late, Joshua's natural athleticism and unyielding determination propelled him through the amateur ranks with lightning speed. In 2010, Joshua made his mark on the international stage at the AIBA World Boxing Championships in Baku, Azerbaijan.
Boxing for the best part of 5 years to study. He's a very intelligent man, has a degree and a master's in. He's going to need all his mental strength here because physically he looks as though he's been outgunned by Anthony Joshua.
Referee has stopped the contest, Phil.
91 plus kilos from 2010, Joshua in the red corner.
His amateur career became a symphony of victories and accolades. From winning the Haringey Box Cup multiple times to claiming the British Amateur Champion title, he was becoming a force to be reckoned with.
Surname was that.
91 plus kilograms. Joshua
Then the stage was set for a defining moment.
Short term, mid term and long term, and I'm still at my short term goal, which is to become a British champion.
At the 2012 Olympic Games held in his hometown of London, Joshua etched his name in sporting history. In a fierce battle against the reigning Olympic champion, Roberto Camarel, Joshua fought with every ounce of his being.
Competing in just his first Olympic Games, with the man wearing blue, crossing out of the orthodox stance, will have other ideas.
Yeah, he just got off the roof a little bit,
and then left, one left hook follow up that game wasn't. Right on the target, and his opponent, from Great Britain, wearing blue, Anthony Joshua, just 22 years of age.
He's got off the walkout again, that's better.
Drives Camarelli back towards the neutral corner on the far side of the ring from our commentary position. Now the two fighters engaging in a rather untidy exchange in the third and final round. Good rally from Joshua. Reception from the crowd greets that word. More left-hand success from Joshua. Not too many moments ago. Joshua back onto the front foot.
Joshua's pulled it back, but needs a couple more, that's better.
He's feeling the pace. 32 years of age, he's had a hard tournament, and this is a spirited rally from Anthony Joshua. He brings about a response, and as the closing bell sounds, Anthony Joshua raises his hands immediately.
Gentlemen, the judges scored at level at 18 points apiece. The winner on countback, an Olympic super heavyweight champion in the blue corner, representing Great Britain, Anthony Joshua!
And when the dust settled, the nation erupted in jubilation as he claimed the gold medal in the super heavyweight division. With Olympic glory still fresh in his heart, Joshua leaped into the professional realm.
The support's good, the potential's good, but I keep my feet on the ground and I still got a long way to go.
Signing with Matchroom Sport.
To be with Matchroom Sports has been a blessing for myself, for my family, for my team. And then outside of that, what Matchroom Sports have done is created a great environment for boxing fans.
He embarked on a path that would bring him face to face with the giants of the heavyweight division.
My goal is to become an ABA champion and then to become a professional boxer. And then I found out about the Olympic boxing as I started to become more of an elite boxer.
On October 5th, 2013, Anthony Joshua made his professional debut at the renowned O2 Arena in London. The stage was set, the lights dimmed, and the crowd held their breath as Joshua faced Emmanuel Leo, an experienced Italian heavyweight.
Middleton for Audley Harrison in 2001. Switch downstairs. Oh, he's got it. Big solid right hand there, has shaken the Italian.
Little did Leo know that he was about to encounter a force of nature, Anthony Joshua.
Joshua chiseled all those long right hands, and Emmanuel Leo is feeling those, has another one going inside. With that unbeaten record of his, the good jabs, Joshua just teeing off with everything at the moment. He's ready to go already. There's another big shot, another couple more, he's still standing, but how much longer, the legs are dipping again.
Joshua unleashed his devastating punching power in mere moments, knocking out Leo in the first round.
That's what the bus is about.
The boxing world had witnessed something extraordinary. An unstoppable force emerging from the shadows, ready to take on all comers.
The punches now accurate. Yep, and the fact that he was never in any hurry.
The future people's champion, Anthony Joshua.
If you're talking about talent, I pick Anthony Joshua. And another thing is that Anthony Joshua also has insane power. Okay. Oh my God, he's got great power, more than anybody else, I think.
With each subsequent fight, Joshua continued to showcase his raw power, remarkable footwork, and explosive combination punching.
First time, it comes as a big shock, and he was badly hurt there.
By the end of 2014, he had amassed an undefeated record of 10 wins, all by knockout.
Shannon Briggs, of the fighter he once was, and a right hand lays him out! In the Joshua story, one single shot, boom.
A testament to his ability to dispatch opponents with incredible speed and precision.
You know, he needs to, there you go. Joshua needs to mix it up a little bit, throw a few more combinations, put them together. And that's what he gets in return. A three-punch combo that rocks the head back. And then Joshua goes to work and puts him on the floor.
That's when you know it is really hot. He didn't have the neck muscles, they're tense for that one.
Joshua get the finish here in round seven. Everybody on their feet. Brazil fighting for his life now, and he's down again. And it's all over. Our Buster's waved it off. He's got nothing left. Anthony Joshua does it again. Still world champion.
Dorian Darche and Michael Sprott were among the notable contenders who fell victim to Joshua's relentless assault.
Taking his time here with Darche. Darche doing a nice job of slipping and getting a decent right hand of his own in. Good bit of work there by the Welshman. Right hand. One big mistake and he was in. Joshua, and he could finish it here. Darche looking to try and find it.
Under the right eye of Darche. Staggered again. This time by a straight left, then caught. Struggling. He's in trouble, and there is an arm, so that's enough, and it is, because Darche wasn't going to go easy. Two rounds, last time out. What can Michael Sprott, who's had eight championship-level fights?
No, not really. I mean, we're looking at two.
And the combination flow early here. Just waiting for the explosive moment. Past his best now, right hand comes through and he's wobbled, he's shaken by that, and Joshua straight on him, and Sprott's in big trouble here. Joshua just teeing off,
and Tyrone
O'Connor says that will do it right there.
Haven't seen.
Stunning. That should have been a bit earlier because Sprott was in big trouble.
Who was this unstoppable force destined to shake the foundations of the heavyweight division? Little did they know that Anthony Joshua was just getting started. But as you all know, the journey of a champion is never smooth.
A lot of people, like, doubted me, saw me as a bad person. A lot of people said, boxing? What do you want to do boxing for? That ain't going to pay your bills. But look, the tables have turned.
Behind the dazzling victories and thunderous knockouts lie the struggles that test their spirit, the obstacles that push them to their limits.
And I always had this feeling that if I keep on messing around, I'm never going to achieve anything in boxing. And I think that was a turning point for me where I said, this is it, boxing or nothing.
And for Anthony Joshua, this journey was no exception.
What he's been through, what he's done, It's all made him the person he is today, and that is Anthony Joshua, professional boxer, Olympic champion, soon to be world champion, hopefully.
After his meteoric rise in the professional ranks, Joshua encountered his first setback at the Commonwealth Games in 2014. Despite being one of the most promising up-and-coming fighters, he was not selected to represent England in the competition.
And the first time I cried a bit. You know that we are weeping, like, coach was there, so I didn't want to burst out. I was like, yeah, I'm good.
But the setback only fueled his fire, and Joshua pushed forward without pause. He sought out the toughest opponents in order to hone his skills, and one man caught his attention, Dillian White. White was a promising British heavyweight with more than enough grit to challenge the young champion in the making. On December 12th, 2015, the two met in an epic showdown at the O2 Arena.
Seconds out, first round.
Officially for the Commonwealth and the vacant British title.
The stakes were high as Joshua sought to prove his worth against a formidable opponent.
White comes through, Joshua sticks his tongue out at White. White in survival mode here already. The legs don't look good at all. And White is starting to come apart here already.
White's got to hold, White's got to hold, he's got to hold.
There's the 5 seconds to get through here. Big swing and a miss from White. Oh, nice uppercut ripping in there. White showing he's got a chin and a heart.
But White was no pushover. He fought with tenacity and skill, matching Joshua shot for shot.
He is not going to get himself into this fight any other way.
But can you take a chance?
The fight went back and forth until, in a moment of fate, Joshua found himself on the receiving end of a devastating left hook. The impact shook him to his core and sent shockwaves through the boxing world.
The power that Dillian White brings in his one-punch knockout power.
But as he stumbled to his corner, Joshua refused to give up.
White just couldn't measure him.
He rose with determination and courage and went toe-to-toe with White again.
Tell him you
this, round six. Anthony Joshua has weathered a storm.
White jabs at him. Joshua's maintaining his distance. That way he's able to counter back like that.
In the end, Joshua emerged victorious with a seventh-round technical knockout over White, proving that he had what it took to succeed in the heavyweight division.
What kind of power White is still carrying at this stage. And again, Joshua finding it too easy to tag him at the moment.
Obviously their own, but he's got him.
Terrific. Finally got him. Is this the breakthrough? White looking to hold on.
He's in round one.
Rocked by that big right hand. Joshua looking to size him up. Gets another right hand through. His own terrific response again from White.
He's in shape. I tell you, to get through all this stuff, he's in shape.
Joshua not letting him off the hook. Howard Foster having a close look now.
But as long as White returns fire once in a while.
There's a grin from White, but the legs are betraying him, and down he goes.
He's hurt.
Surely no way up here. Dramatic and unbelievable at the finish. Joshua.
But Joshua's journey wasn't over yet. Not by a long shot. He was determined to prove himself against the world's best, and he quickly set his sights on Vladimir Klitschko, the reigning heavyweight champion of the world.
Now making his entrance to the ring, welcome the challenger, Eddie Hearn.
The two men would face off for the first time on April 29th, 2017 at the iconic Wembley Stadium in London. It was a monumental clash between the established champion and the hungry up-and-comer, and the entire world watched with bated breath.
Again, it was different with Fury, a totally different experience, because Fury just used to be questions, and I'm going back in the day with Vladimir now.
Yeah, position in so he can come back with a good counter.
Throughout the fight, Joshua faced the relentless power and experience of Klitschko.
He's a jarring, stabbing shot.
Another one.
Shots.
Joshua's not backing up. Look at this. Klitschko has turned this around completely here in this fifth round. He is definitely getting through here, and Joshua's looking really heavy-legged here.
Exhausted.
What a dramatic fifth round this is. The biggest win of his career, and now Anthony Joshua is hanging on a little bit. A big uppercut getting through there as well.
The Ukrainian veteran tested Joshua's resolve, landing thunderous blows that sent shockwaves through the young fighter's body.
It's not quite come yet. Another
jolting right hand sends Joshua down.
But Joshua refused to retreat.
But now on the brink of defeat.
Wow.
How does he respond to adversity? We've not seen this before.
He fought back with an iron will and some of the heaviest punches that Klitschko had ever experienced.
Anybody can look good when it's easy, when you knock them and they fall down.
Finally, after numerous rounds of grueling action, Joshua emerged victorious as he knocked out Klitschko in the 11th round.
Nine games, that is a thing.
It's been on the floor, and it's Joshua off to the fast start again, just as he did in the fifth round. There's Klitschko showing all that experience. God, my goodness me, I thought he was going to go, and he didn't. Massive shot from Joshua, and now Klitschko goes. It was that first uppercut that did the damage. Klitschko down for the second time. Now he's getting a few more seconds here from the referee. Can Klitschko rally again? Is there anything left? It doesn't look like it. Joshua's going for the finish, and that might just be that. Looking in serious distress, will they let this carry on? Given a lot more time by the referee,
but he's in cover neck
as well. Can Joshua put the exclamation point on his performance tonight? Backing up, he's in big trouble. Pinned in the corner here, can't get free. Joshua unloading, and that'll do it.
Cementing his status as one of the premier heavyweights in the world.
He doesn't even have the energy to smile.
Anthony Joshua had finally arrived at the pinnacle of the sport, the undisputed heavyweight champion of the world.
Joshua launches himself.
Indeed, these fights have etched his name into the history books and made him a true champion. But still, to many people, he was a big guy with power, but not the technical skills or finesse to become a true boxing champion. There comes a point in every champion's story when they reach a climax, a moment that defines their legacy, a turning point that defines their destiny. For Anthony Joshua, this pinnacle arrived with a mixture of triumph and bitter disappointment. On December 7th, 2019, Joshua faced Andy Ruiz Jr., a Mexican heavyweight contender. The world watched in awe as these two warriors clashed.
God bless you both. Boxman!
Round one underway. This ended up actually being maybe even a tougher opponent.
You could almost just sense him winning for the moment.
Ruiz tried to come in. Joshua caught Ruiz. And then a left hand from Joshua, but a nice counter from Ruiz up top.
In a shocking upset, Ruiz Jr. unleashed a barrage of punches that sent Joshua to the canvas not once.
Ruiz knocks down Anthony Joshua.
Not twice.
Headed towards the end of the round, and Joshua's down again. Joshua is down for a second time in round number three. He will get up in time to continue.
Hey, walk to me, okay? Look at my hand. Walk to me.
Start of round number seven. Big left hand that stung Ruiz, but then Ruiz right back to Joshua. And Joshua in trouble, losing his footing. He's down again. Joshua is down for a third time tonight.
Joshua scores with a big punch. Ruiz comes right back.
But
Joshua
four times.
Finally landing a big blow, and now another. Can Ruiz counter? Joshua's down again.
The boxing world was left stunned.
Looks so tired, I think he wants out!
How could the seemingly invincible Joshua suffer such a devastating loss?
But it's no excuses, it's my own fault. I got caught with a big shot, and congratulations to him.
But true champions rise from the ashes, and Joshua was determined to reclaim his throne.
I want to get my revenge. I'd love to get a win, get those titles back. You still know my vision and my direction in the sport, that don't change. So on to the next, and we'll see if that's Ruiz.
On December 7th, 2019, in Diriyah, Saudi Arabia, he faced Ruiz Jr. once again.
Here we go again. Rematches of recent Ignite Air. Desert Air in Diriyah, Andy Ruiz Jr.
This time, the story unfolded differently.
First thing I noticed happened for me was, and a right hand.
Good shot.
Beautiful work for Joshua. Left eye coming. Great.
Driven by a hunger for redemption, Joshua fought with precision and purpose.
And Ruiz in trouble.
Landed long, hard, straight right hand, lead left hook. This is good.
And that's what I like.
Round after round, he showcased his resilience, outboxing Ruiz Jr. with calculated combinations and sheer determination.
To unload a combination. Right hook around the temple area.
Anthony Joshua's having to win. That's a good right hand.
Good, the movement's good, but he's also every now and then he's got to hit Ruiz with something hard just to keep him in his place.
Anyway, but there's certainly the extra star
on him. From Joshua, round number seven, when Anthony Joshua's looking for the right hand, Joshua, oh, and it turns, he fights him, spits, I think he trains in bursts as well, as he just attempts to get inside, and a right hand there. And Joshua just unsteady, and here comes.
He tries to hold him or tie him up.
Oh, good beautiful work. There. Lovely work from Joshua.
Yeah, it is. That's what I'm saying. It's good. Stay disciplined. Stay on that himself tonight.
Yeah. And sometimes the best thing is just to keep it simple.
When the final bell rang, Joshua had triumphed.
Joshua, who will be celebrating at the final bell. What a performance!
The judges' scorecards revealed a unanimous decision victory. Vindication for the fallen champion.
Ladies and gentlemen, we go to the scorecards after 12 rounds of boxing. Go to the winner by unanimous decision, the fighting pride of London, England, and once again, the heavyweight champion of the world!
This triumph had immediate and long-lasting consequences. It catapulted Joshua back into the spotlight, reigniting the fire within him.
Careers are all about experience. There's no losing, there's no winning. It's just about creating great memories in this game that we all love. I took my L and I bounced back. Anyone can do it. Life is a roller coaster. What do you want me to do? Give up? I hear certain man saying, oh, I should retire. Come on, man.
Oh, and click at the top right corner to watch Manny Pacquiao's biggest fight.
40 seconds to get it done. Velasquez in big trouble now. The increasing accuracy of Pacquiao's shots making a difference to Velasquez.
The impact of his victory reverberated throughout the sport. Boxing fans eagerly anticipated Joshua's future fights, craving the excitement and drama he brought to the ring. But a heavyweight champion's journey is always challenging, and there was another obstacle coming up for him. Joshua faced new contenders and formidable opponents who tested his skills and resilience. On September 25th, 2021, at Tottenham Hotspur Stadium in London, Joshua faced Alexander Usyk. The undefeated Ukrainian who had his sights set on the heavyweight crown.
The main event of the evening.
The atmosphere was electric as the two warriors squared off.
Challenge yet, Alexander Usyk from the Ukraine, and here we go, Todd Grisham, Darren Barker, and Roy Jones Jr. ringside.
Both fighters fought well for the whole 12 rounds.
Usyk going straight after the champ, he is now. Oh, and again Usyk with a straight left hand, the southpaw scores. Putting on the performance of a lifetime, the back of the legs, and do you believe what we're seeing? Will AJ play it safe, or will he go for the gusto like he did in the first fight, cruiserweight, to try and steal Joshua's world title? That was a slip, but a... Oh, he caught it coming in! Big right for AJ!
And lost move, good jab by Usyk, looking for the backhand again, and
AJ! AJ's got that smile!
Touch out.
Oh, oh, left hand. He almost went down. The champ's still on his feet, though.
Well.
Oh, uppercut to the body. You don't see that too often. And then a swiping right hand. Is that straight right hand from Joshua? 30 seconds to go here in round 9. And what has been a fantastic heavyweight fight, punctuated by another left hand from the challenger. AJ's heavyweight belts. Oh, off balance again with AJ. Good counter right hand from AJ.
Good right hand right there by AJ.
Usyk used his movement and feints to keep Joshua off balance.
Oh, big shot by Usyk.
While Joshua tried to work the body and land his power shots. But on this night, victory eluded Joshua as Usyk showcased his technical brilliance, earning a unanimous decision victory.
A fight of the year contender has Alexander Usyk become the heavyweight champion.
It was a bitter pill to swallow for Joshua, a setback that left him contemplating his next move.
Really hard for me to say I'm proud of myself. I don't feel anything. I'm upset, really, like deep down in my heart. Like, oh man. Oh.
But true champions are defined by their ability to rise from defeat. And so, Anthony Joshua stands at a crossroads, ready to forge a new path.
In my view, as from a mother's perspective, I think he's kind of learned from that. It was a kind of wake-up call. Since then, he's never looked back.
The legacy he has created and his impact on the sport continue to reverberate throughout the boxing world. Joshua is currently in London, where he fought his latest fight against Jermaine Franklin on April 1st, 2023 at the O2 Arena.
Joshua and heavyweight boxing back at London's O2 Arena. Just a smattering of blood around the nose of Joshua.
It was his first fight without a belt on the line since 2015, which he won, and proved that he has the makings of a unified heavyweight champion.
This is brilliant from Joshua. as for those many critics who will be lining up.
Good uppercut on the inside, good exchange.
Two good right hands from Joshua, one the uppercut and one the straight shot, and again he follows up.
Look down, shot out over the top, oh, big uppercut on the inside, they're exchanging.
Terrific work on the inside here.
Good job, good job. Misses with the right hand, but a good job.
Whoa. Oh, big right hand from Joshua. Minute to go in the final round. Recovery from the American, having taken such a heavy shot of his own. Joshua, last few moments of the contest. The bell sounds, and Franklin.
Your winner by unanimous decision.
As the final bell tolls, we step back and reflect on the legacy of a fighter. A legacy forged through sweat, sacrifice, and an unwavering spirit. Joshua's impact extends beyond the confines of the boxing ring. He has inspired countless young and old athletes to pursue their dreams and reach for greatness.
And the gold medal at the Olympics in 2012. That's the gold medal there. And then I brought one more.
His rise to prominence has forever changed the sport, redefining what it means to be a heavyweight champion.
Being heavyweight champion of the world means a lot to myself and means a lot to a lot of people.
From his explosive punching power to his impeccable technique, Joshua's influence is undeniable. But it's not just his in-ring prowess that leaves a lasting mark. Joshua's dedication to his craft and his unwavering work ethic has resonated with fans worldwide, inspiring them to push beyond their own limits.
Failure was kind of like a motivation. I always went back and I just started seeing improvements.
Did Anthony Joshua's journey inspire you? What moments resonated with you the most? We would love to hear your perspective and engage in a discussion about this boxing legend. Click the top right card to watch a related video. Don't forget to like and subscribe to all notifications, and thanks for watching.